In this video, I'm gonna give you 10 tips for when you're applying effects within Premiere Pro. These are gonna be the most common things that I come across as an editor, and these are the types of tricks that I wish I would have known from day one opening up Premiere Pro. Let's dive right in. Most of you are familiar with the concept of copying and pasting clips, but one of the most amazing features inside Premiere Pro that I use every single day, probably every single hour, is pasting attributes. So if you don't know, when you actually hit Command C on Mac and copy this clip right here, I can now paste the attributes of this clip, so this black and white effect, and I have a crop effect going on to any or all of these clips that I highlight. All I have to do is right click and go to paste attributes. That will come up with the paste attributes window, and all of these checkboxes are what attributes you will paste to those clips. So let's say I wanted to just paste the black and white effect, but I didn't want to paste the crop. So I'm going to uncheck crop and hit okay. So now instead of applying the black and white effect to each clip individually, I've done it by pasting that attribute to all of them at the same time. I remember the first time I saw another editor do that, and I was like, what? My mind was blown. And along with that is to remove attributes. I'm going to highlight all of my clips, right click, go to remove attributes. And now I want to make sure that I have everything selected and remove all of the attributes. So I'm gonna hit okay, and now everything has returned back to normal. That's remove and paste attributes. And one more thing that I wanna add to that to make it even faster is the shortcut key. So I'm going to hit Command C to copy these attributes on this clip again. And in order to paste attributes, I could highlight all of these clips and hit Option Command V, then that will bring up your paste attributes. And maybe this time I'll do the crop effect, hit okay, and boom. Next tip, you can now assign an ease out or ease in with a shortcut command to your keyframes. For example, if you wanted to spice up the movement of this linear title coming from the left side of the screen, the easiest way to do something like that would be to download my smooth movement preset pack, available in the description, type in smooth in your effects, and then just drop the smooth in from left, and then you'd be done. That was a plug. In all seriousness though, if you want to add the Easy Ease function with just the click of a shortcut key, go to your shortcuts, that's Option Command K on Mac, and then just look up the keyboard function Ease Out. Click down here on the shortcut until you get a little box like that. And for me, I like to do it as comma for Ease In. I like to do that as period. You can set those up for whatever you want to, but I like to have them as comma and period. Gonna hit okay. So now I'm gonna go to my clip right here. It's still linear. I'm gonna go to my first keyframe, hit comma to ease out, and go to my last keyframe and hit period to ease into that. And now you have ease out and ease in movement. I might even just drag this so it kind of vroom. Neato gang. Speaking of movement in between keyframes, if you wanted to add motion blur to that, it's very easy to do in Premiere Pro by using the transform effect. So I'm gonna go down to my effects window and look up transform, drag that onto this motion blur clip, and using the transform effect, not the motion, not the vector motion, and not any of these motion parameters within the text, just the transform effect, I'm going to hit the stopwatch on the position and I'll have it go out of the screen over here. Then I'll move it to the beginning of the clip and have it come from the other side of the screen. Now I'm gonna move in between those two keyframes. And in order to add motion blur to this title, all you have to do is adjust your shutter angle. So the higher you make the shutter angle, the more motion blur you add. It has a peak of 360. I normally like to start with something like 180 and see how that looks. But as it goes through the screen, you can tell that it has motion blur. Another key thing here is if I were to move it up or down, the motion blur would move with that. Just like before, I could hit comma on this and period and vroom. That's the easiest way to add motion blur to the movement of a shape, a clip, or a title within Premiere Pro. Next tip, if you're looking for some free royalty-free light leaks, film burns, or flares, I like to use a website called cutestockfootage.com. And if you want to apply a light leak, film burn, or flare to your footage, like in between this transition right here, I can drag my light leak onto the timeline in between the two files. I might go over to my effects window, look up cross dissolve, drag that onto the beginning of the clip, drag it onto the end of the clip, make the cross dissolves longer, but shorten the span fan of the light leak. And in order to blend these together, I'm going to go to the effects control window of the light leak, go down to opacity in the blend mode, and choose screen. Now it will fade up into the light leak and transition into the next clip. Same thing with this kind of anamorphic flare look. If you wanted to add that above this clip right here, I would go to the effects controls, same thing underneath opacity, and do screen. Now you kind of have this flare look in there. You can play around with any of these other types of blend modes, but for the most part, when it comes to leaks or flares, I always find that screen is the best blend mode to preserve the color of the clip underneath the leak or the flare while blending in a good amount of the leak or the flare. Which leads us to our next tip of using film overlays. Same concept here. I like to go to cute stock footage for these kind of old-timey black and white film scratch overlays. And if I wanted to put that over something like this clip right here, I would drag that onto the timeline and scale it appropriately. Then I would go down to my blend mode, and instead of screen, because it would make it look like this, what we're gonna do this time is multiply. Now you have this kind of old-timey look. Next tip is global effects mute. So in order to show you that, I've gone back to this example where I have the crop and black and white filter going on every single clip on the timeline right here. On my program monitor, I have this global effects mute button. If you don't see this on your program monitor, just go over here to the plus sign, your button editor, and click and drag your global effects onto the bar. I'm gonna hit okay. And what this does is mute all of the effects. So I'm going to click it, and automatically you can see that it has muted all of the effects on the timeline. What you should pay attention to though is that the effect is still toggled on for all of your clips. So if I were to export this, in fact, I'm gonna hit Command M to export. Right here in the preview, you can see that it's going to export with those effects on. This button is a huge time saver on sequences where you have a bunch of effects on your clips and maybe you have lag on your playback and you just want to see what you're doing. So just click that really quick and you won't have any effects on, but at least you'll be able to see all the playback. Next tip, you can track masks inside Premiere Pro. This comes in really handy with something like the Lumetri color effect. So right here, let's say I just wanted to track the face of this lady and maybe just brighten up the face just a tad bit while darkening everything around so it draws the attention to the face. In order to track this mask to the face, all I have to do is hit the track select mask forward right here and it will do it in the background. And as you can see in the effects control window, these are all the keyframes for this mask, and Premiere Pro has done an amazing job tracking that mask. How cool is that? Now from this point, I could maybe add some feather so it's a little more subtle on what's going on. Now that was just with the Lumetri color effect, but I want to reiterate here that you can do that with any mask. If the effect allows you to create a mask within Premiere Pro, you can track it. The next tip is applying effects to your master clip. Now, what do I mean by your master clip? Well, sticking with the whole Lumetri color that we were just talking about, right here, if I were to adjust any of these parameters, I'm just affecting the Lumetri color effect on this specific violet clip right here. Now what I've done is I've actually taken this violet clip and pasted different parts of it throughout the timeline here. And if you were to affect the master clip, that would affect this clip globally. So let me show you what I mean. I'm gonna delete this Lumetri color. I'm going to go right up here and click on the master tab. And now do exposure, contrast, and again, I'm really just doing extremes so you can really tell that I'm doing something to the image. At this point, what you should see is this little red line underneath the clip, and that's telling me that something has been affected on the master clip globally throughout the whole project. So if I go over here, now that clip has the same color correction, if you could call that a correction to it. Move the playhead along, this clip has the same thing going on with it, so on and so forth. Now, if I wanted to see another place where this effect is shown on the master clip, right here, I'm gonna click on my clip and go to my effects controls. And instead of the effect showing up right here on the singular clip, what I would need to do is go click on the master, and there is my Lumetri color. Just to give you another example of this, I'm going to do that same black and white effect, click and drag that on. And I could go in here and click on this clip, and you don't see anything. You would have to click on the master. Now, if I were to delete the Lumetri color, it's still gonna be black and white because that effect is still there. Now, one of the interesting things would be if I were to go to a singular clip and then start manipulating everything. So let's manipulate the exposure on just this clip. There's the Lumetri color, and I've applied the black and white on it on the global effect. So you can still apply things on singular clips and they won't affect the other clips on the timeline unless you were to apply those effects to the master clip. Hopefully you can see the advantage here, where if you have an interview and all you need to do is color correct that master clip of the interview, as opposed to applying a Lumetri color grade to every single singular clip. Next tip, applying default transitions. There are two types of default transitions that you can use with your keyboard shortcuts. One is a video transition, so something like a cross dissolve, and then the other version would be a cross fade in between two audio clips. Inside the timeline, if I wanted to add a cross dissolve in between both of these clips, I would move my playhead in between both the clips, and then I would hit Command D to add a cross dissolve. Then I can move that however I want to. If you want to change the type of video default transition, what you would want to do is go to Video Transitions, and maybe something like dissolve, and the transition that is highlighted blue is going to be your default transition. If I wanted to change this to something like dip to white, then I would right click and set selected as default transition, boom. Now I'm going to delete my cross dissolve and hit Command D, and now it's going to dip to white really quick to go to that next clip. Now, if you want to apply a default audio transition, for me on a Mac, it would be Shift Command D. The biggest tip that I want to give here though is if you're in the finishing parts of a project and you want to make sure that you don't have any pops in between two clips, you could maybe just highlight all of your audio clips like this and do Shift Command D to apply a little crossfade in between each clip. That way it won't pop in between every single clip. Another key thing with that kind of fade is the duration of it. So in order to change the default duration of your crossfades and cross dissolves, you want to go up to Premiere Pro, Preferences, Timeline, and right here is where you would set the default duration. My audio transition default is 2 frames. And the reason why I do 2 frames is because I want that little crossfade in between all of my clips. The last tip I want to show you is how to save a preset of your effects. Let's say I always do something like this movement with the transform where I scale in clips, and I just want to save this kind of movement as a preset. Well, in order to save something like this as a preset, all I have to do is right click on the effect and hit save preset. Maybe I'll label this scale in example. And there's 3 types of ways that you could save this. Scale is going to automatically compensate the duration of the effect according to the scale of whatever clip you are applying the effect to. Anchoring it to the in or out point is going to keep the duration of the effect the same exact every single time, but it's going to anchor that effect to the beginning or the end. For this particular instance, I'm going to anchor my effect to the beginning because I always want to scale in the clips that I apply this to. So scale an example, I'll hit okay. And now just to show you that I can apply this to any of these, maybe I'll take this lavender clip right here and maybe put it a little bit over that purple clip. I'll go to my effects tab and do scale in example. I click and drag that on and boom. It's super cool and super neato. And if any of the tips that I've given you in this video have helped you in any way, shape or form, could you leave me a thumbs up on the video? Leave me a comment down below on some of the things that you like to do with your effects inside Premiere Pro. I know that's a very broad question, so I don't know, have fun with it. If this is your first time here and you like my teaching style, you can hit the subscribe button. I have 2 videos on the side of the screen that you may like to check out. And until next time, I hope you're out there living a life of abundance. Bye.